I am live. So I just got done doing my online event. And it was actually an event. It was an opportunity event to answer any questions from any potential recruits. Maybe somebody was interested in learning more about what it means to join Tupperware. And that way I could be live with them and I could answer their questions at that time. I don't have my iPad, guys, so I won't be able to see every single one of your comments, and I also won't be able to see who's joining either. I just have my phone and the Mevo. There's a lot going on right now in my house. My mom and my sister are here in the pool. I mean, my nephew's in the pool. And I also forgot to put on my glasses. I literally came running in here after I finished and I logged off my opportunity event. So I don't have my glasses on. I see Paka. That's gotta be Paka. He's the only one that types like, no. But I don't have my iPad. I have to go get that. Right now I'm trying to wash the rice to cook the rice. And by the way, this rice is not for me or Romel. This rice is for my mom, my sister, and the kids. My microwave needs to get cleaned. I haven't cleaned it in a very long time. Just been focused on other things. But let me go get my iPad. So that I can see all your comments. And of course, I tell you guys, no joke, every time I make adobo, the flies manage to make their way into my house and it drives me bonkers. So I actually bought this thing. I'm gonna show you guys in a minute. Let me just move all this stuff out of the way. I bought this thing I found at Walmart and I'm waiting to see how effective it is. Sorry, the iPad was all up in you guys' grill. I'm waiting to see how effective it is. And it is micro USB rechargeable, but it is a little like UV light buzzer thing. And it's supposed to kill fruit flies and flies. There's two big bambucha flies in here right now that I want to see if it the flies will actually go to it. Let me see. It's supposed to like zap them and UV them or some crap like that, but there's like two really fat flies in here right now, and it's because I'm cooking adobo, but I don't know if the flies are going to be, I mean, the that thing is going to work. So we're going to have to, I'm going to have my salt gun. I'm using the Mevo, so the people that have really good eyes, you guys are going to totally see the flies buzzing around the camera. And I'm not ignoring you. I'm focused on looking for my table salt. I need to refill this. Oh, it's already activated. God, keep still, you fatty. You're dead. Okay, I need, there's one more. I'm just waiting for that. It's right there. Okay, I think I got them all. So far, I have not seen any dead bugs in this thing, and I have left this thing on overnight. It comes with a little cleaning brush like this. So you can show this in there and clean off the little zapper. Can you, inside there's like metal, like a little like metal fingers on the inside, and that's what zaps the critters. This outside bar is all plastic, but this thing was like $18 at Walmart, and I really wish, and I'm gonna email this company. It's the company name is Pic, P-I-C, and this was like $18, less than $18. But there's four settings here and I don't have the instructions anymore. Good God. But I can't remember what each setting was for. They need to like put that on a sticker underneath it. Like I'm gonna email them and tell them, you guys gotta make some improvements to this if you guys really want this to sell and work, because so far it has been very disappointing. I get more results shooting the damn flies with the salt gun. So I made chicken adobo in here because it is hecka hot in Hawaii, and I see a fly, but it's on the outside of my screen, but I'm gonna kill it anyways because it's too hot for me to turn on an oven or heck turn on a stove. So I threw a whole bunch of chicken thighs in here. I would say 3 to 4 pounds of chicken thighs, boneless, skinless, and I'm going to lift the camera up so you guys can see inside the pot. Don't mind all the cables. I have to plug my Mevo in. So there it is so far. I did not stir it. And because I put so much chicken inside, I cooked it for 30 minutes. Let me turn the light on. So I did it for 30 minutes. I used apple cider vinegar, soy sauce, and I'm not going to use stevia for this. I use brown sugar, bay leaves, a whole onion, a large onion chopped really, really thick, and fresh garlic, salt and pepper, and a pinch of red pepper flakes, and that's it. Super easy. I'm gonna post the recipe afterwards. So this is not a I would not call this a keto recipe because I use brown sugar. Oh my god, you guys, there's another one. Come on, go in there and get zapped. Can you please go in there and get zapped? Oh, this is killing me. It's because I opened the freaking pot, that's why. Because I opened the pot, they can smell the adobo, so they're all over it. Go online and see. Yeah, I'm going to go online and see if they have instructions. I'm pretty sure it's there. But I'm going to contact them anyways because they really should make it a little bit easier, you know. Oh, my sister is in the back putting her leg up because she can't have water on it. So my sister got bit by her cat the other day, and she also has lupus. And so her body reacted to the cat after the cat bit her. Freaking word, you guys. Either I'm a horrible shot or we just have a crap ton of flies that, you know, because they're, everybody is going in and out right now because they're all at the pool in the back. I missed it. It was on the sponge. So the kids and everybody keeps opening the stupid sliding door, so the flies are making their way in here. So let me just stir this up. So I put this in for 30 minutes, and oh my god, you guys, the meat is just falling apart. So I use apple cider vinegar. Some people like to use white vinegar, but I have apple cider, so I use that. So again, because I put brown sugar in this thing, it is not a keto recipe. Now, depends like what your carb intake is supposed to be for the day. I use 2 tablespoons of brown sugar, and you're not gonna drink the whole pot. So I would still consider this a keto friendly recipe. I would personally, because you're not, I'm gonna close the window because they're all like trying to get up in my space here. Oh my god, this fly just almost attacked me. Oh my god, this fly is gonna get it. Ooh, you're gonna get it. This fly is such a bombucha that the salt, it needs Hawaiian salt. Hold on a minute, it's right there. It doesn't want to die, you guys. I shot it like 3 freaking times and now the baby's awake. This whole video is just going to be of me freaking shooting flies. I don't know why this sucker don't want to die. Oh my, you know what? I'm out of salt. I think that's what it is. Yeah, yeah. Where did it go? Oh, it's stunned. You're going to die now. Hold on a minute. We're going to drown him. There you go. Finally, it's gone. So the baby was sleeping. I'm so sorry, you guys. I'm so distracted today. The baby was sleeping. Emily was throwing a freaking tantrum. And so she woke up. So, Paca, would you say that this thing was somewhat keto? Or not keto at all? I'm sure the keto police are going to be like, no, you put brown sugar. That is not keto. I get it. Let's try the soup first. Yeah. She's tired because I took her for a swim for about 30 minutes, gave her a bath. Oh my god, it's good. I just need a little bit more salt. So I gave her a bath, and then right after that, my sister showed up. So there went that. So I'm just adding like maybe 1/2 tablespoon of salt. I didn't put enough salt in it. I prefer my adobo to be sour, so I think I could have gone with like 1 tablespoon of sugar, but Ramel doesn't like it when it's very sour. So this actually made the chicken super duper tender. See that? All the pieces of chicken are just like falling apart. But I'll post the recipe for you guys. It's super simple. I like using a pressure cooker on days like this where I don't feel like cooking anything. And it's really hot. Because it is, like, every morning I wake up and I'm asking Siri what the temperature is going to be today. Hi, Bren. Hi, Marie. Hi, Rachel. Much better. Hi, Robin. I added a little bit more salt, so that tastes a lot better. Personally, I would really like to have more vinegar in it. But if I do that, Ramel not going to eat them. So I did add a pinch of red pepper flakes. That's something I don't normally do, but I wanted a little bit of a bite to it. It could use a little another pinch, but that's me. I'm going to add a little bit more pepper. And then it's done. So I'm making the rice now. That's going to take 60 minutes. And then the kids can eat. So this is probably one of Emily's favorite dishes. I'm going to just steam up some broccoli and cauliflower to eat with this since we're not doing rice. So Paco, what do you think? Is it still keto? Okay, thanks. I just saw your comment. I don't have my glasses on today. So do you guys like my new shade of Maria? I was in the pool for like probably almost 8 hours today. That's how hot it was. I think I went out there at like 9 to go check the water and make sure it didn't need to get vacuumed because I have a little pool vacuum that I got from, I think, Lowe's. It's one of those that you just attach your water hose and it creates a vacuum and it sucks all the rubbish up into a like a pantyhose sock thing. So I went out there to check the water. The water was really cold this morning. And by like an hour later, I'd say 10 o'clock, it got really hot here. So that was it. I was in the pool. In the pool, out the pool, in the pool, out the pool. So hopefully I'm not too red. Thank you, Hawaiian Tropic, for your SPF 4 tanning lotion. It works great. I like that tanning lotion because it actually keeps me from turning red, but it makes me like a super golden. Do you see this tan? Oh my God, you should look. Can you guys see? Look at this. Can you guys see that? Look at my tan. So I'm not red, but I got really toasty brown. So I was using Hawaiian Tropic SPF 4. Normally, if we go to the beach, I use SPF 30. Hi, Leanne. Oh my gosh, it's been a while. I'm wearing my ears because I never like fix my hair. I literally just took a shower and then I looked at the clock and I'm like, oh my God, it's almost 6. I got to do my online event thingy. So I just threw the ears on. So look at my color. Do you guys like the likey? It's kind of red right here. But it's like, you know when you guys go, I don't know, if you guys go to the beach like all day and then your body, it's like you feel like your body is radiating heat afterwards. Like I feel like the heat is coming out from inside my body. Brenda got tan too from Kaneohe. Try look. It's hard to tell in the light, but earlier I was like super red. And yes, I painted my face on because I had to do this live earlier. Hi, Laura. What's the brand of what, Joanne? The Hawaiian Tropic. You're talking about Hawaiian Tropic. Let me see if I can get the bottle for you. And it's probably an old bottle because that's how long we had them. Emily, can you bring me my suntan lotion from the back? They want to see the bottle. She's making like the, my eyes look pretty. Thank you. I was using my this eyeliner pencil thing from the Wish app that says it's waterproof. And you know what? I used it yesterday and it really is. I mean, it comes off if you're gonna scratch it, but like it didn't smudge in the pool. One day, Aisha, I know. Bruh, I go in the sun for like 10 minutes with no sunblock and I'll get red. Yeah, Joanne. So like when you use like Emily, can you please get my brown bottle? Please. Auntie Joanne wants to see the bottle. I said please. I usually use like SPF 30 Ocean Potion or Copper Tone or whatever. I'm not trying to block out all of it because I do want to get some sun. But the Hawaiian Tropic one works really, really good. Yeah, Joanne, gets going tan. So if you see, I'm very golden brown. Where I almost look like Shelby right now, yeah. Come on, hurry up. But you know, after you pout, sunbathe or whatever, and then you go take a cool shower, I feel like I'm constantly sweating now, and it's just because my skin is hot. So it's this right here. The bottle probably looks different because this sucker is probably old already, but I did not see an expiration date. Yeah, so I don't know how old this thing is, but it works because I did not get burnt. I did not turn red. And it's SPF 4. Like anybody that's, you know, I don't know. They have SPF like 30 and SPF 50 and 100. If you ever use SPF 100, it's like thick. It's like you might as well get clay and put clay on your face. One thing I like about Hawaiian Tropic, it smells good. However, if you're somebody that doesn't like to smell like Waikiki Beach tourist kind smell, then don't, you won't like it. Personally, I like this one. And so while I was sunbathing out there with my oils on, it's not greasy feeling. And that's what I liked about this one. It's literally a lotion. Huh? What? It's on the sink in the bathroom. I just washed it. It's not greasy. So when I put it on, it felt good. When I use like the really higher SPF, like for sun blocking, like I feel like my skin is suffocating and there's just sweat coming out of my pores, you know the kind. But it says it's very water resistant. It has in here, I was reading the thing while I was sitting in the sun because I couldn't look at my phone. It has plumeria flower extract, mango fruit extract, guava fruit extract, papaya fruit extract, and passion fruit flower extract. So it has all that stuff in it. Emily, say that one more time and you're going to get slapped. So I like it because it doesn't smell like straight up coconut. You know what I mean, Joanne? What is that called? That coconut willies? Like that. SPF 70. Yeah, it's the Filipino. The Filipino blood make you come dark. Oh my God, what? Look in my room. So anyway, so pow, and dinner is done. Fruit salad. I like the way that this smells, but that's just my opinion on it. Some people might not like it. Ramel said he doesn't like it because it makes him smell like tourists. But I'm like, whatever. You rather smell like an orange creamsicle, because Ocean Potion smells like orange creamsicle. Personally, I don't really like that orange creamsicle smell. I prefer this one. Yeah, just use that. So anyways, I'm done rambling, guys. How long have I been on rambling with you guys? Oh, only 17 minutes. I feel like I never talked to you guys a long time. Never. No, because she's saying, Jesus Christ. Okay, so let's check on the rice.
Stop talking about me.
Stop talking about you. So this is 4 cups of rice. I put it in the microwave rice maker. I used this finger to measure my water up to there. And I put it in for 16 minutes, so it needs to sit a little bit, but there, it's done. Uncovered. I did it uncovered. Oh, my God. Emily!
Will you put a cartoon on? That's why. What are you watching? She doesn't like that.
That's why hard when you get baby sister. You gotta do everything the baby sister wants. So I'm just gonna flip the rice around. So that's what it looks like fresh after it comes out. I'm just gonna like stir it up.
Will you put a cartoon?
Crossing the rainbow. I did not tell her about crossing the rainbow. So I'm just gonna fluff it up and I'm gonna let this sit for like 5 minutes because this sucker is too hot. Then I'm gonna make the kids their bowl. So this took 30 minutes, 10 minutes to decompress. This took 16 minutes and we're gonna let them rest for 5. So while that's decompressing, you do the rice. You know what I mean? I was not able to do that today because I was doing something else. But dinner is done. I'm just going to have to steam the cauliflower and broccoli later on before Ramel, the kind, come home from paddling. Because we're not going to eat rice, hopefully. It's hard to say no to rice with adobo, but we're going to. Yeah, so you got to do that. Oh my God, Pioneer Chicken. Shelly, Pioneer Chicken was my fave. And growing up, the one we used to go to was in Waipahu. But the reason I loved going to Pioneer Chicken wasn't just the chicken. It was their corn on the cob. And it's the one thing that I remember the most because it was the only chicken place I had it.
Hey!
They had the corn cob wheel. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Hey!
It was this freaking wheel that would spin around like this and the corn cobs would roll in the butter. Do you guys know? No, she's grumbling because Emily's being grouchy. There's Ramel now. I'm guessing that Ramel just gave Paka the boot because now he's on. I made chicken adobo. But there was this wheel and it looked like a pie. It was just like metal slats like this, like a pie. And in each section was a corn cob, and it would just spin around in circles, and it would roll that corn cob in hot butter. Oh my God. And then when they, when you would buy it, you would wrap it in like a plastic bag with a twisty tie, and it was so hot you couldn't touch the corn cob. Oh my God, Pioneer Chicken. They need to bring that back. Remember, you remember Pioneer Chicken? Oh, that was the best. And the picnic baskets, totally. Yep, but the corn was just my freaking ultimate fave. Totally. So dinner is done. I'm going to log off because I'm starting to sweat. It's really hot in the kitchen right now. And I've never even turned on the stove, but it's just hot because the rice is hot. This is hot. The kids are crying. I might end up back in the swimming pool. Oh my God, Taco Bell was next door. You know what? I'm pretty sure Taco Bell is in the same place that it was, girl. Yeah. Oh, this is Jody. Yeah.
Where's your plastic?
What plastic? Yeah, across the street from Leeward. That's what I said, Ramel. That's the one we used to go to. They had the corn cob wheel.
What plastic bag? Just a plain plastic bag.
I don't have.
What? You plenty top of her, but no plastic.
Hello, we don't use plastic bag. We don't go commissary anymore. Yes, this. Oh yeah, the Pioneer sauce too. Oh my God. Anyway, I'm gonna log off because it's really hot. So I will see you guys tomorrow with Lord knows what I'm gonna make. I'm gonna just throw something together. But I'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a great evening. Bye guys.
We can come back again tomorrow.